Do you feel like you're making your dad proud as well?
I hope I am.
With like everything you're doing now with your career, is that who you feel like you're, is that who you're kind of doing it for now?
Yeah, most definitely so. Yeah. There's been times like in my career when I'm thinking,
to the side of my gun and my boxes. I feel like the man I do. Say a prayer to God, forgive me for the things I do. Three pistols outside, I can talk my shit, say a thing or two. I'm in love with money, I love mummy. Even when bands ain't in the mood, ain't bad in straight cap. Bullet the tray clap, run with your friends or defend it. Shoot them and see more and end it. G-Lock, I chat to you and it's extended. Yo, there's a war in the end.
29-year-old Mark Duggan was shot by police in Tottenham. His death sparked riots which spread across the country.
The majority of people in this country know that Mark was executed.
Peaceful protesters say give us answers for what has happened 2 days ago. They didn't get those answers.
Go on.
We see what happened as like, oh, rah, this man got killed by the police and there was riots. And then and that was like the biggest moment. That was one of the biggest moments in the country.
Mm.
Like in the last 20 years, easily one of the biggest moments. And then 8 years later, that man's son is now one of the biggest drill rappers in the UK.
Mm.
Like, have you ever kind of thought about that?
No, I've definitely thought about that still. I don't know how people would take to it. So I wouldn't think how people would take to it, but yeah. Me rapping and kind of becoming someone. It's mad still.
Ends of firing skanks. Hashtag lacking is ended. I never pretended. Spinning your block. Bite. Figure.
So this one here is about Broadwater Farm.
Mm-hmm.
Broadwater Farm? Yeah. It's like a playground one time when I was younger and like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just utilizing the whole estate, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. As you can see in all the videos, when it's time to go back to the trenches to shoot videos, and you'll see the blocker, you know what I'm saying?
It's like every other hood, innit? Like, you know. Things are going on. It's whatever you think goes on, innit?
Mm-hmm.
It's a neighbourhood full of family and culture. Mm. So that's what kind of grew everyone up, do you know what I mean? Yeah. And once again, today we're in music, you know, we're running legitimate businesses and doing our thing. Mm-hmm. It's all from the mannerisms of being brought up well in a nice community.
And a lot of people say Broadwater Falls is notorious, you know what I'm
saying? Yeah, man,
you don't
big
go
man.
At the wrong time, do you know what I'm saying?
Nah, you don't want to go there at the wrong time, but we're polite people, man, we don't hurt no people. Well,
good,
but we don't hurt no one.
But I grew up there. I lived there at first gate when I was at 3-4. My mum was staying with my dad's mum and that in Tanjame. There wasn't no escaping there, even if I wanted to. But yeah, I love the farm, man.
So these are basically funny stories about you and some of the stuff the man has said.
What would you say your funniest memory of banding?
One time, what was it, man? Stole my dad's car, innit? These times driving an Astra these times, like, one of my other dogs.
Yeah, I remember this
another ride, innit? You know what I'm saying? So he's in the other ride, man's following him.
Was in TPO.
When fucking time pack there, man. Yeah. You know Whiteman Road, long road, yeah? Driving, yeah? Cool. Saying that, why I stand still, but like, bro's braked so fast, yeah?
Mm.
Like, when I've tried to brake, it's just crashed straight into bro, like.
Madman.
Bro's like, hey, this is not bro, each of the jaws, like, this is mad, bro. Oh my days, I know he's looking around, like, it was crazy. It was funny, though. Cause man's there laughing, but bro's just getting mad thinking, bro. You got
running
on an
hot block. So you crashed into
it? Nah, Desi was driving.
Yeah.
And I was in the passenger. We had the guys in the next car in front of us. But this is dad's car, isn't it? His dad's going to work. Dad gets on a train. He stole his dad's car. So we're doing road now. Obviously, as he said, just going through Turnpike Lane. And yeah. Well, it's kind of Desi's fault, though.
Why?
The car. Desi don't know how to drive. This is his first time, not even like a test drive. He just jumped in the car, automatic, and we're like 16, 17, we're on the road, we're in an area where we're not meant to be right now. And he's just, yeah, crashed. It's like going mad.
Obviously, the little young, he's done something, there was little CIDs around, so I was running off, but I didn't know what happened, but these times, the bando and a couple of two little young G's done something kind of block, and I ended up getting arrested for it. Funny now, but it weren't funny then, you get me, I was mad.
Only thing I can think of right now is when he crashed on a bike one time. There was a little one, a little ped.
Whose ped was it?
I don't even remember. It wasn't ours, but it was with us.
Basically, there's rumours around, God forbid, and touch wood, and I got stabbed in my arm.
Oh, yeah.
But it's from a bike accident.
Oh.
Even if you go on my latest tunes, it's in the comments, this guy's been stabbed by this guy. And I'm like, God's got me, it's not going to happen to me. You know what I'm saying? Like, my little brother stole a bike. Obviously, that's a little bro, I'm big bro, bike's mine now. At the time I lived in like Bounds Green, I was trying to get to Tottenham. But I wasn't trying to cut to the ends because there's too much police, so here's me at 16, 17 with no helmet. I've got someone on the back. Decent, I can't even ride a bike like that. And I'm on a dual carriageway, but there's like a lorry in front of me. But the lorry's got like some sharp metal at the back you get. Behind the lorry now, there's a car there. But as I've tried to swerve in front of the lorry to go into the other lane, my arm just clipped the sharp metal. But I didn't really clock at first until, because the guy on the back hit his leg and his ankle's kind of out of place to get. So I've heard him screaming and I've just looked at my arm and I've just seen like blood squirting through my whole jumper. Like, my whole jumper was ripped through my t-shirt, through my arm. Yeah, just had to U-turn home. But when I've taken everything off, my arm was just, you get me, squirting up with blood.
What, you didn't go to hospital?
Yeah, no, of course I went to hospital. Of course. I had to stitch that up.
Yeah.
And, yeah, no, it was serious though. Told me if I didn't call them, like, within, like, if I called them about 10 minutes later, I would have bled out or something. I swear, because even when I wrapped the towel around, it was coming through. You know what I mean? Shit. It was coming through, the whole towel was red and, yeah, man.
I hope you learned your lesson from that one.
I didn't. Rock to survive, I'll rob anyone that don't rock with a guy. Shorty never let me hit her in the UK. Whatever you say, she let me hit in the bike. Had dead on her knees, she was begging me please. When I'm driving, I can't give me head in the ride. When I see purple, I get red in my eyes. I'm wet in my life, but hold up.
It's your first solo project. Were there any moments where you were making the tape you thought was challenging? Or did you think the making of the tape was like quite simple, quite easy? Like, how did you kind of view it?
Some bits are challenging. I was about to explain how it was challenging. Like, I might go to studio sometimes and I have writer's block. I'm just wasting the studio time. So that's challenging for me. But most of the time, I just enjoy this.
With a rehab band at the front acting, they look up one time, run, I'm laughing, bro, I'm blasting, dickhead. I play chestnut, checkers, act, not chestnut.
Bro's looking at me so they clot it. What? Got me looking at bro like duh. Catch you with your missus, I ain't gonna lie, I'm doing up you and her.
You and her.
But all days on my Rambo, nowadays my stare.
I just wanna make it to the top, bro, because I'm not. How do I explain this? I'm not where I wanna be in life right now. I'm grateful, God, don't get twisted, but I still feel like there's a lot of me that's going to prove to the world and kind of just push me to be the person I'm meant to be. You know what I'm saying? Without no feds or anyone in my way, just, yeah.
You're in the one. Were you, like, how did this one come about?
Fucking, the label sent the beat to me.
Yeah.
You know me, I spazzed in it and then,
yeah.
I was just thinking who to get on it, so
yeah.
Tried out one, two people. Alright, called him out. Then he was the man for this.
Yeah.
The first I started off with just shooting a shoot at call.
Yeah.
You get me, I was in my front room just high.
come with a rifle, everything's dead if I say it's my cool. Benz jump on a ride or a cycle. What's mons beat it like Michael? 4-4 long nose blindfold, just for the rivals. I'm in Paris by the Eiffel.
We was doing up block on a bicycle. 2 months, X5s, but they had tribal. We'll see the up boys try and dip them. Try to do them like Casimir.
You and Eddie have got hits together. Like, you guys have quite a few songs. Like, what's it like working with an artist like him?
No, this one hits more, cause it's from home. Just for me, just being young. Cause obviously Heads, yeah, used to be called Heads. Used to rap before Heady and that, so I've just always wanted to just make a tune with him, even from just me being in school.
Even a Can't Be Us session with you and Abs and him, was that all, again, like all three of you guys?
Yeah, when all of us together, Heady just messaged me saying, send your number, I've got a tune for you. And yeah, when I heard the tune, I went straight over the next day, my brother. I done 3 different verses on that until I felt like I went the coldest. You get it? The tune's mad. But I just had to, like, kind of step up a little bit.
I'm feeling like cold out black because everyone snapped together. Cause the nine can't chat to the O. Half of them look like they don't own a wetter. I won't lie to the industry. Somebody wants life for their brethren.
Look in the mirror and ask yourself if you've been in the trench.
I don't think people was expecting me to kind of come in like that. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah, innit?
Yeah. Would you say that's one of your best verses?
Most definitely, yeah. Still.
Obviously, you got a song called My Life.
Yeah, bro.
With Simba, it's got a bit of like this Caribbean edge to it. Talk to me about that track and like what that one's all about.
I think Heady's manager texted me saying, type in Afro Swing type beat on YouTube and just see if I can come out of the show and try and work with something. And I was just thinking who I can get on it that would sound the best. And yeah, like 2-3 verses come back, those calm store, but then I was reviewing it. When I had the Simba one, I said, yeah, this is the vibe, this is the, yeah. This is what I need, this is what I needed for this tune store. But yeah.
And obviously it sounds very similar to Taliban's.
Yeah, bro.
But talk to us about that. Was it like, okay, cool, that was something that you wanted to kind of cover, or was it
bro. So basically, I had the beat first.
Okay.
Obviously it's not out yet. But I had the beat first from last year, I done that song. Yeah, bro.
And then you also had a feature with LD, who I think is definitely one of the forefathers in this UK drill thing. What was that like working with him?
I don't know how to explain that, man. I rate LD still from before I started doing, from when I was in school. Headphones in, I was just listening to them guys all. It's kind of like, yeah, that's the type of joy I used to listen to, you get. But obviously, I'm doing my thing now. Doing bam, mate, made the tune.
Were you guys in the same session when you made the track?
Yeah.
So, what was that session like? So, obviously, it's the first time you're in the session with him.
Session was calm, it like, I've known him, I knew him for a couple of years before I've even done a song with him, so it's kind of like a natural thing. Mm-hmm. That makes sense, isn't it? It's kind of like a natural thing. It's not no music buddies that like, DM you can have a tune, like, do you know what I mean? Yeah. So I don't really like making tunes with people unless I like your music. So there's been some tunes man's done that didn't want to do them, but it's for the bag, innit?
Hey, yeah. Well, first of all, tell us the name of this song. Tell us the name of this track.
The name of this track?
Yeah.
Right, if no. Certainly, if no, yeah, still. That's the same as anything, I don't know, until it's ice,
Burger and stepped outside with 25 fries. Slapped me a rapper, he ran to the feds, no, he's out here rapping about too much pride. He lied, turning them off, we tried.
Yo, I'm like, how many man got fried? T1's on the wind, just got done it up, done it, sold the sky. My Yanji's putting in work with his bull rock, causing trauma, I'm so surprised.
So, obviously, you got the hometown track with Kush, Axe, RV, YF, Abra, Cash, and Heady.
It was more my manager that was on everyone to get me, come and do this tune still. Once he heard the beat, he just went to everyone there, sort of like, yo, studio this time. And yeah, man, just come studio still. I just set it and then. Obviously, everyone at first was like, who's going first, who's doing this and that. So I was just like, Tuesday, it's my tune, you get me? I might as well just set the memo. then yeah, people just kind of understood from there what the song was about.
Touch world till my hood into Baghdad. This new era, and I don't rap cat. Over there, them don't do rap cat. One eye closed and I drop it and bang that. Still doing roll the smoke, don't like up time to pass. They put in the back shot. Few clap, you really did clap back. When I ride something, holes in the snap back. Ah!
You get
in there. I got eight by this.
Jumpy.
He's dancing,
isn't he? He always dances.
Yeah. Jumpy Joe.
Me now, hey, my man said he does drugs. Shit, then tell that cat to me now. Tell up that track and chat to me now.
Did you redo the endings?
Yeah, I did the last one. I know everything, but the last one.
God, innit? And the man got talent, you get me, so. Wherever there's talent, if you keep pushing, bro, you're gonna get heard, you get me, bro. Bear man's been rapping, you get me, so. Like, man was bound to catch some sort of attention, you get me?
Infrastructure, innit? One person made it through the door, and another, and then them same people want to bring everyone else through the door. So those ones that are being brought through the door are bringing the next ones through the door. So it's just the infrastructure.
Everyone was doing it as a hobby, other areas, everyone. So no one thought of it as anything until one man's hit it, and then it's just like, it's just kind of like paved the way for everyone else, you know?
I'll say that we just got our own thing, you know? We got our own algorithm, innit? Man's not with Man City, man's a Man United supporter, you get me?
No,
man, they're rivals,
no,
you get me? Man will feed off energy, you know what I'm saying? So like, man's going to this situation, like man's going to another man's studio sessions, all motivation, you know, man's getting around, it's all motivation. So like, the energy's right when you get into the studio and just giving that like, the good feedback and good energy, and like, naturally tunes gonna come out. Like I said, like everyone's got their own talent.
I don't know, it's just the talent that this block brings, yeah, and like with the man name, everyone just wants to see everyone shine around them. As Heavy said in that tune, especially me, I just want to see everyone win as well. So it's like, yeah, one person opens a door, then the next one just comes to you.
A lot of you are in the limelight.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you maintain your friendships even when the internet sometimes try get in between it, when you know certain things might happen, someone's Snapchat's getting hacked, or someone's saying something on the internet, like, and then you guys
question.
Are all together, like, how do you guys then say, oh, like fuck what the internet's saying, like we're just focusing on like what we're doing, like, surely people must feel a type of way still.
It's a mad question still, but well, the guys know I'm loyal and I wouldn't do nothing to jeopardise our friendship, you get it? So it's like, you know me, if there's a problem, let's speak, let's talk it out, but from your bedroom, you get me? Forget how the media and everyone else is going to put it to you, if that makes sense. That's just me. I don't like falling out with friends.
With this tape, you're speaking a lot of deep stuff.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? It's not a drill tape. I don't class this as a
neither do I.
It's rap. And it's got a bit of drill, it's got a bit of rap, it's got a bit of like dancehall vibe, like, it's got a bit of everything. But ultimately it's a rap project. But then even with a lot of the deep stuff that you're talking about, like, was that easy? Was that difficult? Like, how did you find that process? Because I don't think you've really done that before.
Nah, but once again, like, when I'm just by myself, I can talk about certain things. Do you know what I'm saying? So it was kind of like, it didn't affect me when I'm rapping. I wasn't getting upset or anything like that. I was just kind of just telling my life, so.
All I ever wanted was some bricks of yay, some bricks of B. Ram me or the flick on me. Ops get dropped, don't show no sympathy. I'm changing pounds into dirhams up in DXB.
Turn red when he was up next. You see yourself as a role model?
Yeah, I do. To some kids. Just don't want them to pick up the badness of what I'm rapping. Obviously just listen to the music and enjoy. But other than that, yeah. Just kind of just be yourself and just follow your dreams.
I guess for you, you're a father.
Mm.
So, what's that like, man? Like, that's crazy.
Fatherhood is different still. Even before my son was born, I never thought it would be like this. Sometimes I even look at him like, shit, I created someone. You know what I mean? I've got responsibilities now, not only for myself, but for my little one.
Are there any words of wisdom for Bando as he continues to grow and succeed?
Just keep doing your thing and just avoid all the draw-outs.
Come on.
There's always a bigger picture.
Who knows where it is? You're my family, you get me. You're all my, always going to be my little boy, you get me. You're getting older.
Keep Come on.
You're doing your we're only getting to better and bigger places for me.
Always like keep his head up because remember when Bando first really come to this thing, you had Bando, I mean, you had Elz, you had SJ, you know what I'm saying? But now he's doing his kind of owner thing, like he's this artist himself now. Mm. Always here, like, carry on going, even when you're down and that.
Come on.
Keep your head up and just carry on striving, you know what I'm saying, man?
Stay at the music, keep pushing, everything will line up.
Don't watch nothing, don't watch no one, do you know what I mean? Opinions of others ain't important. Keep shining, keep breaking through, keep breaking the barriers as well, you know what I mean? We come up from a system of bare stereotype things, you know what I mean? Let's just continue breaking the barriers down and lead by example, innit? Be a role model to the next generation, do you know what I mean? Obviously, I'm not young as Bando, but I know one day when he's my age, someone that's as young as him, you know, tomorrow, he'll be able to give him the same advice.
Come on.
Yeah, that's that. Think of Bando. Boom.
What do you want people to think when they watch this documentary?
That it's more than what the media portray me to be. Want people to just see me for who I am. For who I am. Do you get it? Like, yeah, it's just my story, really.
Facts. That's it, bro.
Come on.
Yo, before good days, you get bad days. My mommy grew a good boy, but I learned bad ways. Build what a gangway. My mixtape's here, so I told most I feel damn great. And toes bangs are cut him, I just treat him like my dad straight. My nan straight, she done beat, cancer isn't that great. My granddad died when he heard about my dad's case. My son's here, so I just show him pictures of my dad's face. PTSD, I'm getting flashbacks of my dad's way. Stand by P-Shop, truthfully. Shoot you how you been, I'm in the booth with heat. Playing with my Makarov, cause handguns ain't new to me. I ask how you been, you gonna ask me how the shooter been. I've been stressed, no compe Luger T. I had to ask Buta B to check for me. And shout me back ASAP, bro, respectfully. Els wants the lad, I'm trying to get the beam. Trap stars, the only thing I get for free. I could make an M, so won't forget the team. I'm banned, you know. The same kid from Broadwater.